Hello everybody and welcome to our Live with the SCC. We were going to go live and introduce everybody to our Sycamore Thrive YouTube channel. But as it happens with me, sometimes things don't entirely work out. Who knew? I don't have a probably premium subscription to be able to go live and stream live on our YouTube channel. So I will upload and be putting some things to that YouTube channel, and I will be sure to let everybody on our Facebook and our IGTV know. But for now, hopefully everyone who saw our post from earlier just about being able to keep each other safe wearing our face masks can join in. I'll also post this to our IGTV so you can always tune in later. But we were planning on just making sure that everybody is able to have at least some level of comfort with mask wearing as we start to go out and about even more and as we start to come back onto campus. ISU, I think, will be giving everybody two masks to be wearing. And so, you know, I've been watching everybody as well as educating Bella on proper mask wearing techniques. So I thought that would be an awesome idea to be able to share with everybody who joins us. And so we've got those quite bright so you can kind of check out what all of those techniques look like. But today we wanted to also just talk about the general comfort. I know a lot of people who wear the mask feel some anxiety and some stress with that. A lot of people even talk about having some difficulty breathing. One of the important things to recognize is that just within your body, when you put that mask on, right, you create kind of like this heat barrier. So it makes your temperature go up. And we've talked a lot about this fight and flight and automatic responses that happen in your body. So that increase in heat can make it feel as though it is more difficult to breathe. But now the caveat is if you have respiratory problems, issues that you discussed with your doctor, then mask wearing and breathing might be difficult. But if we're talking about some of the psychological effects, then we've got some tips for you today, right? But there are some very real things that happen that we can combat as long as we're not dealing with that medical side of things. So just that little excerpt, if it is medical, then listen to us, but talk to your doctor too, right? But there are the psychological impacts that happen with just putting this mask on. Psychologically, when you put this mask on, everyone, I want you to remember that we're kind of covering up our face and we are reminding ourselves that things are different. And I don't know about you, Sarah, but how easy, how hard is it to adjust with different? It kind of reminds us that there are some scary things going on, right? And so already we're asking ourselves to be able to emotionally recognize and deal with that, because if we are feeling some anxiety, some stress, some fear, then right there we're increasing that heart rate, that respiration, and that's going to make it more difficult to breathe in the mask. Sometimes even just that automatic thought that I'm going to put this mask on and I can't breathe is again going to make all of those automatic responses happen. And so we're acknowledging that that can happen. This is something very new, and so psychologically, physiologically, we've got things happening, but if we just take a moment to get back to our breath, as we've been talking about so much in our mindfulness and meditation, then we can really help to activate, again, that parasympathetic nervous system so that we are helping to alleviate or at least relieve some of those physiological and psychological effects that are happening. So we've got our masks. Also remember, we have, and I will upload this to YouTube too, a lot of different breathing and breath techniques that we've talked about with our mindfulness and meditation. But today I have a few more. So, go ahead and mask up. Okay. Following those nice proper procedures, we've got it nice and secure on our face, right? Nice and secure. Remembering, it's not under my nose. It's also not a chin mask, right? Not going to sling it from my elbows, all of those great things that we talked about. But we've got it on. It does change the breath a little bit. My knees in the side of the breath a little bit. But we're going to start simple and then move a little bit more in depth. And so I'm going to have Sarah keep her mask on. I'm going to take mine off just to make sure that everybody can hear me as I speak. But let's keep it simple. The first thing that we're going to have Sarah try is just a simple breath and count technique. And so we're just gonna do this in counts of four. So we're gonna inhale for four counts, and I'll count it, and then we're going to pause and hold that breath for four counts. and then we're going to release it for four counts, right? And so just kind of settling in for a moment, feeling that breath, noticing if you're starting to get anxious or maybe you're already feeling anxious, and we're going to practice. So let's take that breath in for 1, 2, 3, 4. Nice and slow and gentle. Now let's hold for 1, 2, 3, 4. Now release. 1, 2, 3, 4. Go ahead and return to a couple normal breaths. Okay, but I want to try this again. So as we're ready, I'm going to slow this down a little bit, just deepening that breath, right? So let's bring it in. Pour that breath in on 1, 2, 3, 4. Holding. 1, 2, 3, 4. Release. 1, 2, 3, 4. Pause, and again, bring it in. 1, 2, 3, 4. Hold. 1, 2, 3, 4. Release. 1, 2, 3, 4. Pause. Return to your normal breathing. How did that feel?
So I guess the first time around, just going a little bit quicker, it was a little bit difficult. I noticed when you did slow down the first round, I was kind of anxious to get that breath in, so I had to kind of work through that. So the second time was a little bit better. Third time was even better.
So what Sarah's saying is a great point, is that as you work on deepening that breath, even holding, you can slow down your counts, work with where you're at. I just want you to kind of get that feel and the rhythm. The most important part of this is that breath hold in the middle. When I have you take that inhale in and then you hold and you release, it can feel somewhat uncomfortable and sometimes we're working through that, but what is actually happening is that we are kind of triggering your brain to recognize that it has enough oxygen. We're not tricking it, you know, even if you didn't, it's sort of a still thing to do, but it triggers a response in your brain when we have that hold in the middle to acknowledge, to recognize that there is enough air intake coming in. And so if we are changing the brain response, right, then hopefully we're changing the physiological and then the psychological worries that are coming through. So that's the reason behind it. There's the science. Now that you have that, let's try it one more time and we'll do two rounds again. Or maybe we could go for three. Let's try three rounds this time. So, three rounds, take a few normal breaths, in and out. And as we're ready, on that breath in, counting for 1, 2, 3, 4. Holding, 1, 2, 3, 4. Releasing, 1, 2, 3, 4. Pause. Breath in. 1, 2, 3, 4. Holding. 1, 2, 3, 4. Release. 1, slow, 2, 3, 4. Again, gently bring it in. 1, 2, 3, 4. Holding. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now release. 1, 2, 3, 4. Pause. Back to your normal breath cycle.
How did it feel that time? It's like if you got to do anything, I'm going to be honest with you. Working on breath counts.
The other great thing is when you are doing those breath counts, we're also kind of engaging your mind. So we're pulling it into that counting of that breath. We've worked on some breath count meditations that are available on our IGTV, and that breath count meditation pulls you out of some of the worries that are happening in your mind and just back into this moment and recognizing again that you are bringing that breath in. So it helps with that mindful piece, as well as kind of triggering what's happening in your brain to recognize that you are getting enough oxygen. So that is a really simple one that you can try, just being able to bring that breath in. The other one that you can do, I'm not following proper mask procedures as I put this down, but usually, remember, for our stuff, we would have a nice little paper towel or something, paper bag, but I have my essential oils, right? So I have tangerine, and you can put a little bit of tangerine. Our citrus scents can be kind of energizing, maybe a scent that just is soothing and calming to you, maybe some lavender, but putting that a little bit in there, maybe eucalyptus to open up those passageways. So now we're adding that sense of smell to our breath. And so we've got that nice essential oil in there. Now it's going to back up. Okay, well. And so that really kind of promotes me to breathe deep. Find that soothing place, right? Maybe even closing our eyes, right? But we have that scent in there that activates that sense of smell, and that is a great way to, again, just inspire us, to remind us to breathe that in deeply, just pulling that breath into maybe a diaphragmatic breath, deep into your diaphragmatic breath, right, pulling it deep, bring that sense of smell in, that tangerine, that lavender, whatever it might be, again, soothing, calming, slowing us down, and breathing with ease, and through any discomfort that a mask might be providing there, and letting happen. And so, another simple, easy technique to use as we get used to wearing the mask. So, shall we move on to one that's a little bit longer?
Let's go for it.
Alright. So we're going to try another one. Get my mask down. I am sitting it down with the exterior onto this, right? Because I am being careful. I know you guys might laugh at what I put on that post, but even mine, it looks the same, right? From side to side. So I always want to be safe and be sure I've got the right side up on my mouth. So. Alright, so we've got our masks on, right? And we're going to take this a little bit deeper with our breath work. So we've tried two simple exercises. Now let's bring this a little bit more. So we're noticing our breath. We're checking in with how we're feeling with this mask. What's going on with our emotions and our thoughts right now. We're checking in with what's happening within our body, our heart rate, our breath rate. Just doing a check. And then we're going to focus on that breath. We might even take a moment to close our eyes. And feel the breath. Begin to just pull that breath deeply in. Past the lungs, into the belly. Feel that breath as it comes to the nose. Notice the temperature of the breath. Feel it flow all the way down to your belly. Really connect with that breath as it comes in. Now feel the belly as it falls back in and we slowly release that breath. Feel that breath as it flows out of your nose. Slowly bring the breath in and gently release the breath out. Just breathe. Take a moment to acknowledge that we have our breath. Take a moment to connect with that awareness that we can gather our complete breath. Take a moment to just be with the flow of our breath in and our breath out. Calmly breathing. We are breathing with ease. And can feel our breath, our life force flowing through our nose, deep into our belly. Parts of our bodies are breath. We can gently, slowly release that breath out. Keeping your awareness lightly on that breath. Gently on the breath. Mindfully noticing how the breath feels. Stay with that breath, knowing that our mind might wander to the many worries that are out there right now, the thoughts of the discomfort. It's okay if our mind wanders. Pull it back to the breath. Maybe silently saying in our heads, breathing in, I know I am breathing in. Breathing out, I know I am breathing out. Acknowledge thoughts as they come. Allow them to just release. Just let them go. Come back to breathing in. I know I am breathing in. Breathing out. I know I am breathing out. Stay with the breath. That gentle awareness. Longer. Acknowledge how the back to this moment, opening our eyes. And just reflecting on how did that feel? Campus, this is going to be an entirely new experience, and we don't know what to expect, which is going to lead to anxiety, to stress. It's those changes, and so I like what Sarah was saying, because it is important for us to practice these things. I even have Bella wearing her mask and trying it out right now as we think about what going back to school for her will look like, you know, and so trying this. You have some different techniques. You know, Sarah can tune into what we're doing here, sticking, you know, her AirPods in and listening to the sound of my lovely voice before she goes into the grocery store to see if that will help her calm. You know, but there are also those small tips and techniques that you can use just as you're getting ready to go into the classroom or as you're putting the mask on, remembering just the four counts, that hold of the breath to help, you know, your brain acknowledge the fact that there is enough oxygen, using those essential oils and those smells. There are small things that don't take as much time, but can be very effective as well. And so hopefully we've been able to provide you with some ideas and some ways to help with the mask anxiety. Above all, know that you're not alone if you are feeling discomfort with this right now. I think that it's a very common emotion, and so even if you need some help dealing with this, know that you can get a hold of us, and we are happy to be there to help work through all the anxieties that come as we look at getting back on track and getting back to campus. So hopefully this was helpful. We'll be back, and I will make sure to let everyone know as we get YouTube actually up and going with our Sycamore Thrive. Very excited about that. Obviously,
technology is
not always my friend, but we're going to get it. So hopefully this was helpful, and we will be back with you tomorrow for our Yin Yoga Flow. So have a wonderful rest of the day, everybody. Thanks for joining us.